guys. Guess what's our menu for today? Based on the ingredients. I am cooking sinigang. So there. Onions and tomatoes. As you see, I cut it in a chunk, not like small slices. And then I have the sparrow. And also long beans are called sitaw. And then I'm also using this Shanghai bok choy. And of course, the most important ingredient to me, which is pork chop. So I use pork chop because it's more healthy than the pork belly. So, but you have an option to use any kind of meat you like. I prefer this kind of meat. Okay, so I'm just gonna prepare and then let's cook. See ya. So it's ready. I'm just gonna pour everything. There you go. And then I'm just gonna cover it and let it boil for a while. And my sinigang, I only use Mamacita sinigang sa sampalo. So it's all prepared and ready. Okay, the taro is optional, so it's up to you if you want to use it or not. So anyways, as I said, I already have boiling water here, and it's ready for us to cook now the pork chop. So I have the pork chop here, and I'm just gonna pour it. According to your taste. And then some peppers. Ground peppers. And then as you can see, the meat is already boiling. Yeah, so the reason why I let it boil for a few minutes so that the flavor in the meat will absorb the flavor in the soup. So now it's ready to put the taro. The reason why I don't put a taro at the beginning is I don't want it to overcook. And then it's gonna get mushy and it's gonna disappear in the soup. So there you go. It's boil again for a few minutes. Then we can add our vegetables to our sinigang. So as you can see, the meat is already boiling. So now we can start adding some of our vegetables, which is the beans. Then cover it. Can actually add now your Mamacita sinigang mix. So it's up to you how much you want to use. If you want more sour, put more. If you want just not to sour this, just what based on how much or how you want your sinigang taste. So there you go, and now you can add the eggplant. I don't have okra, so usually when I cook my sinigang, I always have the okra, but this time I don't have it available, so but this is still okay. Okay, and let it boil again. Most of your vegetable is almost cooked, then you can add the bok choy. So anyway, I haven't tasted it yet, so I'm gonna try to taste it now. Yeah, it's good. It's a little bit more salt, just add. Depends on your taste. Now to add the bok choy. This time I used 2 packs. It's what is this called? Konti na lang siya. So I used 2 packs this time. Bok choy is it's only 3 minutes to cook, so don't overcook it. Almost done. As you can see, you see the color, the green color is really vibrant. And then, bring it to sinigang. It's cooked. It's already cooked. Ready for lunch.